my husband. I am in utter disbelief over your sudden death. I have indeed lost a lovely gem and can only look to the Almighty God, whom you faithfully serve as a staunch SDA member. I met Sir John almost 3 decades ago. We became the best of friends and later married in 1998. The vows for better, for worse, till death do us part, has been fulfilled and death has truly left us apart. After our marriage, we lived in Hackney, in London, with our 4 children from 1996 to 2002. After returning to Ghana, he would pay us visits to London, and I also visited Accra. In London, my husband was industrious and was among the founding members of the MPP UK chapter and the SDA church in the UK. Kwaido, you were a loving husband, but at times you let me stand as if we were shared anything. As if we never shared anything. I am left with many unanswered questions. Death, why are you so cruel? You just snatched my dear from me on 3rd July 2020. I will never forget that fateful Wednesday when both of us were on admission at different hospitals. Honorable, although I was loving and kind, even to the extent of remitting in hard times, your concern for me surpassed mine. I have been in a state of denial since I began writing this piece. I remain in a state of deep despair and confusion. I am completely broken. And it hurts even more because I have lost my friend, brother, uncle, father, and importantly, a loving husband. Since you left, I have heard friends and family tell me that it is well and that I shall be fine. Darling, I will not be fine without you, considering my sickness and health issues. Where will you be to display your compassion and companionship when I fall sick again? Who will buy medicine for me? Who will give me consoling words in time of weakness? From where? From the grave? Is that possible? Only God can tell. You always call me a ghost, to which I responded, Nikwedu. What a remarkable, confident, eloquent, and handsome person my life was blessed with all these years. My husband was jovial, loving, forgiving, lenient, and prayerful. He was public-spirited, a unifier, and a giver. Life is a struggle that needs to be fought. We had many turbulent times in our life journey, but your positive outlook on life and great sense of looking on to God and your hard work made every storm that arose disperse into nothingness. The Lord our Maker has given you the eternal rest that you needed. May your noble deeds in the Lord and good examples cheer us on as we strive to continue your godly deeds. With a grateful heart, I commit you into the mighty hands of our Lord and Savior. Sleep well in God's perfect peace. Amen. Sakra Wondo Ayokufuahi, bless me and your children, especially your son Yao Efriye Kwekuya, who has stood in your place as a father. Continue to bless us and guide us. Peace be unto you. to lie soundly in the bosom of Abraham. Demi Fabie, Ben Maba, Demi Fabie, Abimpanana, Nitien Yamuse, Nikuru Yadofo, Emma, Renan, and Tiffany Money Day, 98. Yet, my super 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 super
Oh,